All right. Hey everyone, hi, I'm here with Lisa and we're going to be recording one of our crafts that we're going to do. And we're going to use these little beads and some pipe cleaners to make some Indian corn. So this is easier than it looks. We're going to go ahead and get started. And the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take two of your pipe cleaners. And Lisa, I'm going to help you do the twisting on this because this is what's a little tricky. I'm going to make it in a cross and then I'm going to bend this over because I have to like make them hook together. So really I've just twisted that around here so that now it will stay together because that's going to be the base of my corn. I'm also going to add one more piece so that my ear of corn is a little bit thicker. And again, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm really just going to twist it around here. This looks like I'm making a mess of this right here, but I'm going to be able to straighten it out. So here we go, just like that. So now, that was the hardest part of the whole thing, is just helping get this put together. And you want it to be centered. Now what Lisa's going to do is she's going to take these, and Lisa, you're going to start to put your beads on here. And I looked in the store to try to find some Indian corn, and I probably should have looked at Meijer, but I couldn't find any. Indian corn really is regular corn. Lisa, you start putting your beads on, okay? You can go ahead and start putting beads on here. Regular corn, but it's really beautiful because the corn kernels are in a variety of colors. And there's reds and oranges and browns and even some kind of like purplish blues sometimes. So this is kind of the best we could find for our beads. And so Lisa's just going to continue to put these beads on here until all F. And Lisa, you can choose whatever you want.
Yeah.
Stop. Okay, so we are moving right along here with our ear of Indian corn. Lisa's got four of these ready. And I see that what she's done when she gets to the end of this, she's kind of tipping this forward a little bit so that when you move over to a new stick, your beads, all your hard work, they don't all roll off on the table and down on the floor. So we're going to come back to Lisa one more time when she gets this finished. She's just got two left here. All right. It looks like you're doing a good job, Lisa. Are we on?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So we're back, and Lisa has finished this up. And now this is the part where we're going to start to bring these up. We're going to pull on this a little bit. We're going to bring these up together. Now, if you don't have a good grip, you might have to get rid of it. I think this one might have one extra bead here just to, because the thing we have to do is we're going to try to keep these together. And get all of our tops together here. And actually, what I'm going to do is just first of all, just twist these two. Then I might twist, these two a little bit. Just to kind of keep things in order here a little bit from losing our beads because Lisa worked really hard on getting all these on here. Twist maybe those two together. Now we can bring them all together up here. They're not going to fall off. Oop, that one came a little bit untwisted here. Okay, I'm going to bring them all together up here. And I'm actually going to even kind of hold onto it like this and squeeze it. Now we're going to try our best. Ooh, here's a long one. I'm going to wrap that around all of them, just like that. Then I can take these others, kind of bend them out a little bit so they look like the tassels on the corn. And I'm going to squeeze this kind of a little bit more into a shape of a corn cob here. Alrighty. So now, Lisa, spread them out a little bit here. And Lisa, how do you like your Indian corn?
Like it.
I think it turned out really well. I think you did a nice job on that. It's kind of, it's nice and colorful, isn't it? It looks really good. All right. So before we finish, we've got this, but some people, this might be a little tricky. It's a little challenging.
Yeah.
So we have another option too. So we've got, this is in your packet, it's an Indian, it's a corn dot to dot. After you connect your dots, the other thing you could do is take some paint, and I really like for something like this, just using a Q-tip. And Lisa, all you're going to do, I'm going to move this over here so you can reach it, you're just going to take this, drop it down in, and you're going to color the Indian corn. I probably try to get all my oranges on first. This has a lot of, go ahead Lisa, you keep going. This has a lot of parts to it. There is another one in here that has a few less pieces of corn. But you could create a colorful piece of Indian corn just by using paints. And I know a lot of people like painting. So this is something you might want to think about trying too. And you can do both or all three. So, all right. Well, I hope you have fun making your Indian corn. Lisa, you did a great job again as being my craft helper here. So good job. All right.